So let's talk about a different type of disc herniation and a different type of problem that disc issues can cause our patients. All right. So this is a patient. This is actually a cheerleader. She's 45, a very active, very fit person who has been training all her life, right? Is a working mom. And she's been dealing with chronic low back pain, right? We've all had either ourselves or someone in our family that has chronic low back pain. My own mom dealt with it for over 25 years, so I've lived through it. And her problem is a little bit different, right? If you look at her x-rays, she's standing straight, right? But if you look at that space at the very bottom right here, you see how collapsed it is compared to the level above, right? Because she's had a lot of wear and tear, right? That the water in that jello, in the Boston cream, has slowly withered away. And so the problem she's having is not really pinched nerve down the leg. The problem is that she has no more shock absorption, right? So every time she stands, she gets to go to get in the car, she wants to go run. I mean, forget about it. She can't even run anymore, right? Because she has no shock absorption. So we're gonna look at her MRI now. And you can see that this disc just doesn't look normal, right? It looks crummy looking, right? You can see that it's bulging out a little bit, bulging out, right? You can see it's herniated here. But guess what? If the nerves are okay, the nerves are not getting pinched in the same way that the other person was, right? The problem is that every time she stands up, this is just collapsing on each other. And guess what? There's nerve endings that go all the way around that disc. And that causes back pain. Because what happens is these inflammatory cytokines come out and they inflame those nerves. And that causes back pain. We call this discogenic back pain, right? That's pain that's coming from the disc, right? This is a form of disc herniation, but very different in terms of what we can do for it, right? So what do we do typically for these patients? Typically, we wait and we have them do physical therapy, right? What do we want to do with physical therapy? We want to build these muscles. These are the multifidi muscles or our paraspinal muscles in our back that keep us upright, right? So exercises like yoga, which I love, or Pilates, those help to build our core, right? So physical therapists will work with the patient to see if they can build these structures up, right? To take the load off the front, off the disc, right? So think about it. If I have a stronger muscle in my back, I'm gonna have to put less load on my disc, which is in the front, right? So a lot of our patients get better by simply doing really good physical therapy, right? We have therapists that work with us one-on-one and we speak to them on a daily basis to figure out how we can customize that treatment to get these patients back to their lives, right? So in the case of this patient, this cheerleader that I'm talking to you about, she had done therapy for more than a year. She wasn't getting better, right? So what are the options? She's young, she's healthy. It's just a disc problem, right? The great news is now we can replace the disc, right? We don't have to do a fusion anymore, right? Even 15, 20 years ago, the only answer was a fusion. And now we can preserve your motion and get you back to your life a lot faster. So I'm gonna show you what that looks like. So to look at the next slide, this is an example of a disc replacement for the lower back, a lower back herniation that wasn't causing a pinched nerve, but it was causing severe low back pain for years, right? And this patient went home the next day, right? I watched her walk down the hall, and now she's doing everything she loves to do. In fact, she was really tearful and really, really happy and excited beyond her expectations in terms of what she was able to do with this new disc that she has, right? Because this allows her disc to move again properly. It takes the load off the other disc. And in fact, if you look at the data here is very clear. There's three times less risk of another problem when you get a disc replacement versus a fusion for this problem.